Right now, the affiliate applications are 60-something a week, and we're overwhelmed, we're overrun, and, you know, I don't know that I need the word getting out much better. You know, it's everyone's really busy, and I know there's a lot of affiliates, too, that are pulling in people in large numbers, and there's a lot going on. The miracle would be to just survive the current growth rate without worrying too much about marketing. It's my problem, it's not yours. I have a reflexive bad reaction to the term marketing. And for me, marketing has come to mean anything that you do to increase business that doesn't directly improve product or service. So, you know, let's do a Groupon. Horrible fucking idea. Let's put fuchsia colored flyers under the windshield wipers of every car at the mall. That's another bad idea, you know? And those are marketing ideas, and I have no evidence, I've seen no evidence anywhere in the world that it does anything. The Groupon thing got a whole shitload of new people all paying half price, chased out the old ones, and it actually crushed a couple of affiliates already. You know, I mean, actually destroyed their business. They will shut their doors because of Groupon. I'm all about branding, and branding is in fact, our business strategy is brand development. And so what are we going to get word about? We're going to get word out about what it is that the affiliates do, what it is that their trainers do. We're going to get word out that this is a program, a concept, a brand committed to effectively making people better. Better at what? At everything they do. I mean, you get to decide. What is it that would make you better? Write it down. CrossFit for 6 months. You'll come back, look at the list. You go, yeah, this helped. Whatever the hell you put on it. Be a better dad. Be more effective in the courtroom as an attorney. I don't care what it is. You know, write those things down. Lower my cholesterol. Reduce my blood pressure. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. It's interesting the belief set that, you know, it's like this is a cult, right? And people ask all the time. And we've always like, no, it's not a cult, you know? And so I went through this phase like, well, maybe it is, and we don't know. I mean, I'd be a fucked up cult, you know? I don't know. So we started asking like, well, what would make us a cult or not? And I was like, well, you know, I tell you what, we got no real recruiting effort. I'm not asking anyone to do anything, ever, unless you're a client. You have to pay me for me to ask you to do something. And I don't care if you leave, there's the door. You know, and that's not really how cults go, right? They're always looking for new people, and when you want to go, the doors are locked, and out comes the Kool-Aid, right? It gets weird. I see none of that, and I was like, well, what is the belief set that unites us all, you know? And because, man, we got black, white, pink, transgender, gay, left, right, they're all here, you know, we're all, the whole of humanity is represented to some extent. What is it that unites us in a belief system? I figure it's really easy. It's that there are some fundamental lifestyle patterns that you can affect that will dramatically change your life for the better. And that is what? Meat and vegetables, nuts and seeds, some fruit, little starch, no sugar, and constantly varied high intensity functional movement will make you a very different, better person. First belief. Second one. That these adaptations are optimized in a communal environment where we share and work together. And I tell you what, man, you get as good as you think you can get on a Concept 2 rower in your garage all by yourself and put a few more rowers and some friends on there and you got a whole different ball game. You know, I used to talk with cyclists that were talking about their cycling, who do you ride with? And they go by myself. I go, oh, let me guess, your wheel's always in front. You know, you win every time, right? You haven't had a bicycling experience until you're riding with a friend that would rather die today than let your wheel get in front of theirs. That's bicycling. And we provide all of that for each other. That and the cheerleading. You know, you ever notice that the last one in the door is cheered louder than the first one in? You know, I mean, that's amazing. So simple belief system. There are some salient changes you can make in lifestyle that will profoundly affect you for the better. And again, these changes are optimized in the presence of others, in sharing that endeavor, that stimulus with other people. That's all we're asking anyone to believe. And boy, that's not a lot, is it? Well, it is. Not in terms of stretching your imagination, but it's a profound belief set with a profound impact, and it is at the heart of the growth of everything we're doing here. Everything we're doing here.